Hi guys, my name is ShyGamerMaile and welcome to my Let's Play of Tokyo Mirage Sessions Sharp FE. This is the first Let's Play on my channel, so I figured why not start with something I really enjoy, and I am a huge RPG fan. Final Fantasy, Persona, just anything that's like a JRPG. So this game is by Atlas. And Atlas publishes games like Persona 3, Persona 4, Shin Megami Tensei. You also have the upcoming Persona 5, which has been in the gaming news a lot. And then you also have some lesser known titles like Trauma Center. And for all of you who are strategy RPG fans, they made this really excellent game called Stella Glow. So I am also a huge Fire Emblem fan. I recently played all three Fire Emblem Fates games. I played Fire Emblem Awakening. Back in the day, I played Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. And I am familiar with the story of Shadow Dragon. So this game has been a huge treat. I've been spending a lot of time playing it. And I figured, why not replay it and share my experience with you guys? So without further ado, why don't we start this Let's Play? So first select a game difficulty. This setting adjusts the difficulty of battles. It does not affect the story, so please select what fits your needs. This difficulty can be changed at any time from the game's main menu in settings. So there's friendly, which only appears after you lose a lot on easy, which I unfortunately did. And this is for people who kind of just want to explore the story. There's easy, who for people who kind of just want to have a leisurely, slow time, who are kind of new to Atlas RPGs. So if you're new to Shin Megami Tensei or Persona, you should start on this level. There's normal for people who are familiar with Atlas games, or who are just playing the game for the first time. This is where you start. And then for those who are like RPG fanatics, you should start on hard. Now, I'm kind of rusty with this game, or with Atlas games in general, but so I'm probably going to start at normal. If I need to move lower, then that's what I'll do. So here, begin the game with normal difficulty setting, yes. Expeditious Hunter, that's what I got. That's the only one I got. But in this Let's Play, we will not use it at all. Unless you guys want me to, like, make a short little video about what Expeditious Hunter is like, then I'll play it for you guys, but otherwise, all my grinding is going to be off-camera. So, to access a downloadable Venter dungeon, you must progress to a certain point within the story. So, probably just past the prologue, which is what we're going to play right now. And now, we're going to have a cutscene, and I'll be quiet so you guys can enjoy it. This game is a work of fiction. Any similarities between its content and existing groups or persons, living or dead, is purely coincidental. Alright, now we're into the main game here. And it's quite a colorful game, as you can see. Atlas is always really good about making interesting settings and just beautiful stuff. Alright, so now we have kind of some control. This is our main character Itsuki, and Itsuki is quite a tech-savvy guy, and one of the coolest things about this game is that your Wii U gamepad kind of functions as a cell phone. So down here I have a view of Itsuki's phone, and I can see all the text messages he's sending his buddy Toma. So he's carrying a communication tool called Topic. It's linked to the Wii U gamepad, you receive messages, and you can see it. So, let's answer the phone right now. So right now, Toma's apologizing because he's running late from a stage show, and I can tell him to don't worry about it, or I can be a jerk and tell him, well, I'm going home. But Itsuki is a nice guy, so we're just gonna tell him not to worry about it. Now Toma's saying thanks and he's really sorry, and now he's saying he saw our friend Itsuki today in Odaiba, and he's wondering why he would have seen her there, and he's asking Itsuki, well, did she tell you about what she was doing today? And Itsuki's saying, nope. So Toma's saying, oh, it was probably someone else then. I don't know why she would be in Odaiba. And he sent us a little sticker that says, here I go. Guess I'll just wander around a bit then. Looks like we have someone familiar here. So, I can control a camera here, and we're just gonna walk around a little bit and explore. This game is centered a lot on, Japanese idol culture. It's a very eccentric game, and at first I wasn't really sure how to feel about it, but once you kind of let go of your expectations, it becomes a lot more fun. A poster Lloyd Tiki, it's popular online. With a program like this, anyone can compose songs. So it's kind of a callback to the Vocaloid stuff, and Tiki is a character from Fire Emblem Awakening and Fire Emblem, Emblem Shadow Dragon. Wow, tongue twister there. Curious Song got first place on the charts 3 weeks in a row. That's so amazing. If you pass this audition, then you might even be able to work together with Kirio, right? My friend's auditioning too. I'm looking forward to seeing her. So Kirio is the person that we were listening to at the beginning. She sang the song Reincarnation. Reincarnation is always at the top of the charts, seems like. I can't believe how much they went into, how much effort they put into, like, making all the songs and making this game look so good. So right now, we're just gonna come over and we're gonna talk to our friend Tsubasa. Seems she wasn't expecting to see us today. But she has been caught.
Tsubasa?
So, this is kind of cool. You can choose your responses. So I can say, yeah, pretty awesome, or Kirio, as if I don't know her. So I'm just going to say, yeah, pretty awesome, because again, the way I play Itsuki, he's a nice guy, kind of.
すごい.
He sounds like he's humoring her. Oop, she's a fangirl. Danger. I'll get around to it. But I won't. Yep, he's humoring her. And she knows it.
いつき君は幼馴染なんだから、もっと私のお願いを真剣に聞くべきだと思う。決めた。キリアは聞かなかったらパフェをおごってもらいます。もちろん特大の。それくらいならおごるけど、そこまでキリアを布教しなくても。
She wants to talk to you about something, Itsuki.
いつき君とキリアの話。See?
まあ、キリアの話は置いといて、話を戻すと、翼って大玉で何か用事？うまくごまかせたと思ったのに。Your
plan to distract him failed.
いやいや、新世代のアイドル発掘オーディション、ワンオブミレニアムに出場予定の方は、受付まで集合してください。
Sounds like something's going on in the back. If Tome is going to be a while, I might as well check it out. So Tsubasa's awfully nervous about something, and she just happened to run off as this idol competition was about to happen, so I'm pretty sure she just entered. By the way Itsuki's written, he kind of reminds me of the lead of the oblivious hero of every... He just reminds me of the oblivious lead of every romance anime ever, where he's kind of oblivious, he's a good guy, he's kind of an everyman, but he doesn't know how attractive he is to other women. I kind of find that funny. It's just anime trope.
新世代のアイドル発掘オーディションワンオブミレニアムも今回で最終選考。私は司会の50位テルです。さてさて、この中からデビューの栄冠を手にするのは果たして誰か。会場の皆さんも気になってますよね。
Well, yes, yes we are. It's not like they can say no.
私もです。
So now we have a bunch of idols in a bunch of eccentric costumes. Kind of reminds me of an American beauty pageant, in a way. And of course, Tsubasa is there, and she's the only girl who isn't dressed eccentrically, and the crowd is somehow surprised by this, or they think she's pretty. I'm surprised he didn't see that coming. I mean, to please you. She's that nervous. The crowd finds that endearing, of course. Well, gee, she's up on the stage with the other contestants, Itsuki. I wonder what she's doing. And we have a member of Organization 13 behind Tsubasa in an alternate colored robe. The most generic answer gets the largest reaction. I wonder who that friend was. There we go, a heartfelt answer. An elaboration. You don't ask that question, bro. Yeah, awkward. We don't ask these questions, Gojuin.
Tsubasa-chan no oneesan wa idol no Oribe Ayaha-san desu yo ne?
Hai. So desu.
We don't ask these things.
Itte kure dake. Konna taisetsuna jōhō dōshite tamatteru kana?
What does this have to do with her being a good idol?
Akarukute uta ga jōzu de.
でも、翼ちゃんのお姉さんは5年前のいわゆるこけら落とし消失事件で
During the mass disappearance, she disappeared.
なんか質問変じゃね？こけら落とし消失事件って昔
役者とか観客が集団失踪したあれ
か? I like the descriptor names.
消えてしまった大好きな姉を思い悲しむ少女。なんという悲劇。私も涙なしでは語れません。
Going too far. Too far.
しかしですよ。ここで問題です。翼さん。あなたの大いなる才能と引き換えに大好きなお姉さんに会えるとしたらどうしますか?
なの?
実はあなたのお姉さん、オリベ・アヤハさんをこの場に呼んでいます。
Well, that escalated quickly. That escalated very quickly. Organization 13 is taking everyone's hearts.Performa, persona, performa, persona. Now loading. All right.
Nani ga okotteru?
Oh my.
お前たち絶対にそいつを逃がすな。あれの依り代の最有力候補だ。
いやー Oh my
翼
Yeah
助けて樹くん。
What is going on, I wonder?
Tsubasa!
We had all those people just suddenly collapse after Gojuin took their hearts. Or whatever that shining power is. I was in Kingdom Hearts mode for a second there. Whoops! We do have to save her, Itsuki.Press Y to open the main menu. When you wish to save your progress, select System from the main menu to save your game. Be sure to save your progress often. Note that as you progress through the game, various functions will be added to the menu. Okay, cool. This is another thing I like about this game, the power to save anytime, anywhere. I'm gonna come down, and I'm just gonna save over this one. This one I was just doing a little bit of testing for a Let's Play. So...We're gonna go through this mirror and chase after Tsubasa. Let's go on through, Itsuki. This is our tutorial world. It's a pretty straightforward dungeon in comparison to the rest of this game.
ここ一体
No, we're not, Itsuki. We really aren't. It's Tiki!
Isoide!
Huh?
あの人が危ない。この奥へ、急いで。
I'm having flashbacks to The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword at the beginning, where you have to chase after Fi to find Goddess Sword at the beginning of the game. We're gonna have to stop every couple steps to sort of, yep, with the story. Oh, I'm getting a text message from Toma. Toma's asking where I am. I'm still in Daitama, but I'm in some weird place I've never seen before. Toma, oh crud, that's not good. You know this place? He wants me to get out, but Itsuki said we're not leaving because we're going to save Tsubasa. Keep continuing on, trucking on, trucking on, trucking on, so we can get to this next section. Alright. We heard someone scream, so something must be happening. So let's just go in that general direction. What was that? I'm not sure either, Itsuki, but we'll sure discover, won't we?
Whoop.
Yeah, I would run too. Jump, 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 jump. Yes. Run. Run, 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 run. We are running, Itsuki. As far away from the ghostly man as possible. We have no time to think, Itsuki. We just need to go.
Tsubasa!
Yokosu.
Yokosu. Run. Now. Don't turn around, just run.
Ah!
And here we have our first Mirage. And it's Crom from Fire Emblem Awakening. Don't argue with the ghostly man, Itsuki. Just don't. Your friend is choking to death. Yeah, just go. How about you, Rasengan? The ghost, just like you did with the ghostly man. That might help a little bit. Oh my, it's Sailor Moon. Complete with the bright transformation and the sparkling hair. Yep, it's definitely Sailor Moon. Can't help it, guys. Sorry.
Shinjirare.
Uwa! Ken ga shabetta. Sono koe. Moshikashite sakki no aoi omake mitai na hito?
Ah. Kizuitara Ken ni natte ita.
Somehow.
So daro.
Kiyotsukete.
Daijoubu da. Ore ga tsuite iru.
A second ago, they acted like they knew exactly what they were doing, and now they're freaking out, and now they're somewhat confident again. They even know what the form was called, so I don't know. Anyway, so this is the basic command system for this game, and it's remarkably similar to Persona 3 Portable and Persona 4. The original Persona 3 had this really terrible battle system where you could only control the main character, and then the other characters were computer controlled, and sometimes they would mess up the attributes and your entire boss battle would be ruined. So this is a much more streamlined and just overall better experience. So first, I'm gonna start by feeling out these guys, their weaknesses. In this game, later on, you have added sort of attacks. So we can't do that right now, but so for now, I'm just gonna start by feeling out their weaknesses, and we're gonna start here with a thunder spell. We don't need any healing yet, and Tsubasa's principally a healer, So I'm just gonna go in and knock this guy out. We'll take a little damage, but that's okay. Turn-based RPGs aren't really popular anymore, and I can understand that because of the whole action RPG thing. But sometimes it's nice to go back to your roots a little bit, and this game is definitely a treat on that end. So let's start by taking this guy out. We do not need to heal yet, so I'm just gonna keep whittling away at this guy's HP. Oop, we took a little damage. I'm not gonna worry about it though. Let's see if he's can be hurt by swords. He can be weak against swords. We don't need to heal yet. Let's just conserve stuff. And we win! Our first battle. And we have our first level up, and this is one of my favorite things about this game. We have the little Fire Emblem level up theme, which is a cool little nod to the series.
なんとか倒せたようだな。戻ることもできるみたいね。まだ状況が理解できんが、俺の名がクロムということだけは覚えている。クロムか。ありがとう。おかげで翼を助けることができた。
俺はイツキ、アオイイツキって言うんだ。アオイイツキか。ん？こちらこそ礼を言わせてくれ。お前の内に秘めた輝きが俺の闇を払ってくれたんだ。ありがとう。そしてよろしく、イツキ。
We have the Blue-Haired Lord Alliance for this game. This is Kaida from Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon. She's Marth's fiancé. Don't hide how you feel, Tsubasa. They're the shadow. Your true self. Another anime trope. Or video game trope in general. Amnesia. Unwanted company is putting it a little lightly. We do need to get out of here. Alive would be preferable. Alright, guys. I'm going to put a stop right here. I hope you guys enjoyed your first episode of this game. So if you liked it, please leave a comment below, subscribe, and just tell me what you thought. If you would like me to continue, just let me know. So this was our first episode. We came a long way. We rescued our friend Tsubasa after she was kidnapped. We got our partners. We witnessed the fantastical Sailor Moon-like transformation into our, I guess, Carnage forms or Faiah Emburem forms. And now we're just gonna try to get out next time. So, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I'll see you guys next time.